There were a number of surprises during this project. The first and largest surprise for the computational members of the team was that this is even possible. The fact that our biology colleagues can actually construct or reconstruct a frog cell by cell and produce a millimeter-sized creature that walks along the bottom of a petri dish that is about as far from a frog as you can imagine. On the computational side, we construct a virtual world inside a supercomputer. We then give to the AI a description of the two building blocks that it's able to build with: simulated frog skin cells and simulated frog hard muscle cells. We then told the AI to randomly combine these two cell types together to produce a millimeter-sized robot built from simulated frog cells, which have since been nicknamed the Xenobots. The AI repeated this, combining and recombining cell types millions of times. And the goal is to try and combine those two cell types to produce something that walks across the bottom of a simulated petri dish. Doug Blackiston, our microsurgeon, then took that design and built the Xenobot from actual frog skin cells and actual frog heart muscle cells. When he placed it in a physical petri dish, the physical Xenobot walked more or less how the AI predicted it would. So now we can direct an AI to build biobots. We can view these biobots as a new type of model system that sits at the intersection of basal cognition, developmental biology, computer science, and robotics. If you were to look inside the supercomputer, it looks like a video game. You'd see this virtual creature that is moving along on the bottom of a virtual petri dish. But in the second stage of the experiment, when we actually construct one of these Xenobots, it is definitely something tangible. One class of applications we hope comes out of this is things like non-invasive drug delivery inside the human body, doing non-invasive surgery in the brain. The AI actually could discover novel rearrangements of biological tissue. We're also quite surprised at what designs the AI came up with. We were expecting something that had sort of four legs and would walk along the bottom of the petri dish. But if you look at some of the Xenobots, they don't look like any particular organism that exists in nature. AI isn't shackled to the kinds of designs that Mother Nature has already discovered.